like go in and try to find what they want.
Yeah, yeah, I agree. Toussaint is not going to run out the clock. That's not their style at all. I think they will be the aggressor a lot of the time in this matchup. We're going to get started right now. We're starting on Battlefield. Makes sense. I actually don't really know how the counter picks work in this set. I feel like it's so dependent on the flow of the set in general, right?
Definitely. Either of these characters could want Dreamland, depending on why they feel like they're winning and losing.
Ooh. Okay. Every time Puff lands an up air, I display that I am not a Puff main, because I think every Puff up air is a rest, even when it's very clearly not. Nice hyper float up air into Nair there by Laud. So quick. A nice little, I don't know, that was almost, it's probably like 27% or something, right? That's a lot in this matchup.
Yeah, it definitely is a lot. In this matchup, it feels like every hit, even like a 14% hit, that could be the
kill.
That's
a bomb. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Does it from a big range because Laud knows that it'll just kill him too? Oh, reads that roll so well.
Yeah, when you're up in percent, it's just not worth it.
Yeah, so when Laud was giving HBox trouble before this turned into a really campy matchup between the two of them, before they started timing out every single game, it was because Laud's ability to just beat HBox in close quarters in landing situations was insane. Laud would power shield every single HBox attack, and it's not necessarily that the power shield itself is good, it's that he's only putting up shield at the last minute. It shows like how much he's maximizing his time, right? And you can see that he's really just kind of getting in on Puff, getting these up airs, getting these nairs, and playing the scrambles, playing the scraps really well. Not scrambles, because it's actually more controlled than that. I misspoke.
We are seeing, though, like, not like a horizontal focus gameplay from Peach anymore in general, because, like, horizontally, Puff's gonna win back air. I mean, like, Peach's forward air and back air are big, but Puff's is just bigger. But then if you can see Peach getting close to Puff, getting nairs, getting under Puff, getting up airs, and playing that more scrappy game, I think that is how Laud's gonna win this. And the turnups are gonna be the key to getting in on Puff. I don't think that Laud, see, Toussaint is gonna approach if Laud is pulling turnups. I don't think we're gonna see them really like try to pull like 100 turnups in a row like we might versus like,
I don't know. They have been pretty turnip heavy so far, but I hear what you're saying, right? Laud is trying to engage and win with hitboxes a lot of the time. That was beautiful. I think that there's a really complex mix-up going there, which is, oh, that's a stitch face. That's the best thing Peach can pull in this matchup.
Yeah.
I'll shut up for a second to see what happens with it. Okay, it's gone. But I think there's a complex mix-up going on here where Toussaint knows that Laud is really good out of shield. Hyperfloats let you move faster out of shield by using the double jump momentum for Peach. And so Toussaint tries to bait an aerial out of shield, and instead Laud is like dropping turnip out of shield right there, knows that we're already at second level of the mix-up before we even seen it played one time.
Yeah. Yeah. Wow, these turnips. Laud using them in pretty much every way you could use a turnip, and more, because we have seen Bomb, Mr. Saturn, and Stitch Face.
Yeah. Laud should make a cookbook that's 50 ways to cook a turnip.
50 ways to cook a turnip. If the Peach players got together and did that, that'd be great. That'd be a lot of fun.
I mean, there's the Captain Falcon cookbook. I want to see the Peach cookbook, which does exist, actually, I think, maybe. Or no, the Sheik cookbook came out. But the Peach cookbook with just turnips. It's just ways to use turnips.
I always thought it was cool how in, like, old, a lot of characters have items that you can like throw and pick up.
Ooh.
Like most notably like Zero Suit.
Yeah.
I always thought that'd be cool in Melee. If those
Zero Suit doesn't have it in ult, right? It's only in
Brawl.
Brawl.
Oh, just that's
because she doesn't do the animation. Yeah, they're separate characters Smash 4 on. So she doesn't do the armor removing animation. She just spawns in as Zero Suit. But I hear what you're saying and I agree. There's a lot of cool tech and ways to use it. Okay, nice. And the Nair there, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, we're seeing, like, Fair is going to be hard for...
That's wow. Dead.
Okay. Wow. Surprising to see anyone combo Peach with that many hits.
That's another stitch. Yeah, but it doesn't quite connect. I think Laud was trying to hide it there, maybe, by running away that way. But Toussaint recognized. Dot Eyes is also a pretty big deal in this matchup.
Yeah, we're talking about the timer.
So much. Oh, yeah. We could time out. And it doesn't really feel like they've been playing too evasive. They've just been picking their spots, right?
Yeah, so this is why when we tried doing 6 minutes at Nightclub once, we said that it was actually a bad idea.
Because on floaty matchup, it just forces stuff to time.
Yeah, this might not time out. I mean, these players, it's just sometimes the natural pace of the game goes 6 or 7 minutes. Why force those games to become timeouts? It doesn't really make sense.
I think at this point, one of them would have to force it. Okay, I want to see that. That's great. I want to see Toussaint not roll ever again. Because Laude has been insane at punishing the rolls, right? That's what I'm saying. And sometimes you have to. Peach is one of the best characters at forcing rolls in the game because of how... Ooh, bad DI from Toussaint and a Beam Sword. Laude just throws... That's another Sid that could close it out. But Peach is so good at forcing rolls because of how... Of how float cancel just gives you extra frame advantage on shield, right?
Yeah.
But has been reading those rolls every single time. I mean, I guess what else can Puff do to escape?
Maybe up smash out of shield. Or
yeah, but that's a big gamble.
For sure. Yeah, I mean, Puff, you know, not the character, not the most grounded character. Toussaint probably more grounded than most Puffs, but...
Okay, so I've been wondering what Laude is doing with, you know how he's doing these immediate float fares that aren't, the hitbox isn't even really coming out and he's landing before? I wonder if he sees Toussaint approaching, if he's going to extend the float so the hitbox does come out. Because it's just a matter of holding Y for a little bit longer, right? Is that it? That's so cool if that's what he's doing.
Yeah, I think so, because, like, Peach can end float at any time, and I think a lot of us are used to Peach doing that, like, instant, where you just, like, do a float, like, the way other characters would do, like a shuffle aerial.
Yeah.
But you don't need to do it that way as Peach. You can hang out there a little longer and mess with the timings, like other characters can.
Yeah, I'm curious. I'm gonna ask a Peach main. I'm gonna go find Nico and ask afterwards if that's what Watt is doing, or if it's just, like, a movement thing that's trying to bait in. Because they're doing it when they're pretty far away from Toussaint. I don't know.
Yeah. I do love, speaking of movement things Laude's doing, the way that Laude will, like, suddenly change course in the air using their double jump.
Yeah.
It's really throwing Toussaint off, and it's letting Laude approach in ways where Toussaint, I don't think, is expecting for Laude to move forward. Wow.
Nice. Toussaint just manages to sneak in there and get that trail. It didn't turn into too much, but I like the way that they managed to get in. It was a different avenue attack than we've seen going in diagonally from the side platform. A lot of the time, that means you get nared by Peach, but if you can catch it while Peach is pulling a turnip, makes sense.
Yeah, I mean, turnips definitely, Toussaint are going to be looking to punish them, but...
Right there. That was a turnip punish.
Let's see, because turnips are definitely the way that Laude won that last game.
Yeah. You're right. Even with nothing off of the special pulls, right? None of the special pulls amounted to anything. Yeah, actually, they got some shield pressure with a dot eyes and a stitch face, but none of the big hits that we expected.
No, definitely not. But the pressure was there, and it definitely changed the course of the neutral.
Laude won the first game. That was another stitch face, by the way.
Wow. Yeah, and I think we're really seeing, like, Laude's focus is on getting close and getting in air, not necessarily, like, spacing from as far as Peach can space. That's so interesting to me. I don't think it's the way you see Peach play in a lot of matchups. Normally, I feel like Peach is a very, like, mid-range character, but we're seeing Laude go for either, like, super far play of turnips or super close play with nairs.
Mm-hmm. Oh, and that... If Toussaint drifts in there and up air ends their stock, and that's what Laude was looking for there, or just a nair or something. But both of these characters are kill percent. Peach more so, but a strong hit on Puff can definitely do it.
Yeah, strong up air. But Toussaint is not, Laude is really playing the grounded game, trying to get under Toussaint, and Toussaint is not going to let them.
It's always been a hallmark of Laude's play. They're able to play grounded, outspace people with Peach's dash dance more than anyone else.
Yeah, I love Laude's ground movement. I think Peach has extremely, like, unique ground movement. I really like seeing Peaches use it.
Whoever gets the first stock here in this matchup, that's always a big deal.
This is a 3 minute first stock.
Yeah, this one might go to time. We said it might not, but I think Toussaint is choosing to play this now. A little bit more patient. Wow!
Meta Knight!
That was a clever way to get that. Catches Laude reaching, a rare thing for Laude, honestly. And now Laude needs to close it out. If you take more back airs, I mean, everything is like a needle. It's like acupuncture, but bad, Andrew.
I think that's called being assassinated.
Yeah.
Yeah, Laude is moving forward, I think, with really the hopes of getting like next to or under Toussaint.
Oh, okay.
But Toussaint is maintaining their spacing really well.
Okay. Toussaint lapping a little bit. Toussaint, I know what was going through Toussaint's mind right there, and it's that one of Toussaint's most famous clips of all time is a Mr. Saturn combo on Wally, and they were thinking, I'm going to do it again. I'm going to get another clip. And so they were just trying to get something cool happening there.
Don't
and then
puff.
It didn't work, but they still got some percent, so.
Don't Puff and Mr. Saturn look like they'd be friends?
Puff? Friends?
Puff?
They do. They do.
They do, right? Mr. Saturn is friend-shaped. I've always liked that guy. Silly little guy.
Ooh.
Yeah, Toussaint actually the one getting under Laude.
Yeah. Not how you usually see this matchup playing out, right?
No, yeah. Wow, two has really committed to the horizontal and under strategy. They're just not gonna take any position but a good one. But that's how you do it, right?
That's a stitch, right? Yeah, I think it was. So many, that's the fourth or fifth stitch of the set. I mean, Laude's been pulling a lot of turnips, but that still feels like a lot. Toussaint has not gotten hit by one yet though, so. Oh, Phantom shield poke.
Yeah, weird little Phantom.
I like that from Laude. Laude has to take some big swings now, just trying to read jumps from Toussaint. He knows that this game is going to time, by the way, if you guys had any doubts about it. And so Laude knows that he's in a race, and there's 3 minutes left on the clock now.
Yeah. I mean, at this point, like, you know, I feel like the traditional mentality is like, even when you're down, don't change your game plan. But when the timer when the timer starts becoming part of it, you have to change your game plan. You don't have enough time to enact what you would do if you were up. Okay.
Toussaint might be the most visually expressive top player while playing. I think more than anyone. In Peach Puff even, and look at how much they're reeling in their seat. They're smiling, they're laughing, their eyes are popping out of their head. Not right now, while they're just off on the side of the stage, but it'll happen.
The percents are getting closer, though. I think this is where like a special turnip kill could really swing the match.
Yeah, I agree, but it's looking pretty dire. There we go. See, look at Toussaint laughing right there just because they got nared. That's great.
Yeah, jumping out of their seat.
What's going through their head? Why was that nair so funny to Toussaint, do you think? Because it means nothing. Because it's futile. Oh. Because at this point, who cares?
Yeah,
it's an evil laugh.
It is.
Oh my, it's definitely an evil laugh.
Two is definitely trying to get in Laude's head. Definitely trying to break Laude. Laude, one of the most stoic top players, I think.
Yeah, but does not enjoy playing this matchup. Does not enjoy playing this matchup, as most Peaches do not.
Yeah, I mean, historically, Puff's one of Puff's best matchups in the top tiers, one of Peach's worst.
Yep, and we can see why. Just so hard for Peach to catch Puff, force an interaction once Puff has the lead. Listen, we said Toussaint wasn't going to camp. Toussaint very frequently is very aggressive, will resort to camping when they need to. I mean, I think this is just over. I think there's literally no way for Laude to get the percent that they need to win at this point. So.
Yeah. Let's see if Toussaint waits on the Angel platform. Nope.
They don't? That was a huge misplay.
Yeah. Because now it's like, okay, can Laude get the damage to win?
I mean, it's still, I think unless Toussaint stood in place and crouched, I don't know if they would be able to. I think even if they just stood in place, the knockback of Peach's moves would not make it possible. They need multiple crouch canceled down smashes.
We did see a bizarre SD from HBox, though. I don't know. I mean, okay, now it's...
And that's a kill, and take a stretch. Yeah, who cares? Just gonna taunt. Law's gonna think about the next game. Yeah, there you go. I see the Peaches muttering to themselves in the corner. You see that? Triff and Polish are having a consortium on how to save their brethren.
I know. They're literally real-time analyzing, like, all right, if we got to play this person in bracket, what are we going to do?
Both of them in losers, though. We're still winner's side here, right? No, this is losers. Oh, wow. This is... Who did Laud lose to?
Moki.
Oh, Moki. Oh. Interesting.
Moki quietly just very far in bracket. Not the word you usually use to describe the way that guy plays.
Yeah, I think Moki is seeded. I think he is the eighth seed at this tournament, so he's seeded to make top eight. But Laud was a matchup that some people were saying could be tough for him. So, good stuff from them. Laud using a lot of sub floats. You can tell when Peach's dress is like clipping into the ground that she's using a sub float. Gets her lower than just a regular float by holding down and Y would do. Means that you can get underneath back air, potentially get an up air or a forward out, air out, right?
Yeah, yeah. And I definitely want to talk about the stage a little bit, because I think that Laud's thinking here is that they do want a lot of room, and they don't want the platforms for Toussaint to land on and like be safe on and maybe even dodge turnips with.
Yeah, it's interesting, because I felt like Laud has been at his best when in close quarters. I don't know. They've played way more of this matchup than I have or ever will, so.
It's also possible, honestly, like, in matchups without chain grabs, FD can be a very much a comfort pick, just because, like, you know, FOD has the randomly moving platform. Yoshi has Randall. Like, FD is a very, very, like, comforting stage for a lot of players.
Yeah, and Mr. Saturn gets the most use in this matchup for Peach, I think, out of any other matchup. Maybe Marth it's really good in, too. But being able to whittle down Jigglypuff's already not great shield gives Peach one way to aggress on Jigglypuff, and Jigglypuff obviously does not want to get shield broken, so. I like the way Laud used our friend, Mr. Saturn. Again, reading the roll. Big percent deficit, but Laud could get a kill with a strong nair. Up air will definitely kill.
Yeah, I think we're seeing those sub floats that you were talking about. Laud trying to get sub float up air under an aerial, but Toussaint is fine staying low to the ground. Wow.
I think it might end up being a back air. Okay, more up air attempt. Yeah, there's a back air.
Yup. Toussaint.
Stitch.
Oh, okay. Okay, this could be it. We haven't... That's the first Stitch kill.
First hit. Really big one. Doesn't have to go through the rigmarole of taking Jigglypuff stock and can potentially get more damage here. A lot more damage. 34 is nothing to scoff at in this matchup.
Yeah. I mean, in case you at home haven't really thought about it, Marth Tipper and Falcon Knee do 20%. So 34 off of one hit. Marth fully charged neutral B does 28.
Yeah, and in this matchup especially, again, you can see Laud's power shield so good. For those of you wondering about power shield, it doesn't actually allow you to like act any sooner with aerials, which is usually what Laud chooses, right? So it doesn't make that much of a difference. It just pushes you back and it allows you to use any grounded moves immediately. Just drop shield and then use them. This is big. Laud going to try to go for a turnip setup here. Okay, not that much. But again, the reason why those power shields are notable is because it means that Laud is being actionable up until the last frames that he can, right? So trying to convince Toussaint that he's doing something other than shielding, only putting up shield when he absolutely needs to, really, really valuable because it means that he could be throwing out an up air or a nair or something else that Toussaint has to think about.
Yeah, definitely shield in this matchup is going to play a pivotal role for both of these characters. Where Laud has been using shield a lot to try to get in. And Toussaint is definitely going to try to avoid being shield as much as possible. Yeah. I don't know. All right, so I do think we're seeing Laud now. Where Effie is giving Laud a good mix of ability to play the, like, the fighting game without platforms to, like, interrupt. Mm-hmm. But also the turnip game. Yeah. To run away and throw turnips.
Yep. There's a PG Stats video on how Laud uses turnips uniquely to take space. Shoutouts to Brentos Fresh for writing that one. Really good video. And you're seeing it on display right now.
Yeah, I gotta watch that one. That sounds like a really interesting topic.
Yeah, there's some stats in it too in terms of how many turnips Laud pulls.
More than other peaches?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it's not because he's always playing like a runaway play style. In this matchup, you can see he's still trying to get in Puff space, even with a more than a percent, more than a full stock lead, right?
Mm-mm.
Yeah,
but he uses them to set up how he wants to take that space.
Yeah, yeah. Laud definitely is just making sure that they come in with a turn up.
Yeah.
But they're definitely not just content to throw turn ups indefinitely.
Yeah, I mean, so that up throw makes sense, right? But I think Laud's going to probably up throw again soon and then try to approach. Okay, they are mostly forward throwing. It's something I've noticed that's really interesting.
Yeah.
Getting out of the corner.
The up throw, kind of even similar to the full jump down throw, just keeping the turn up out for a long time.
Yeah, and preventing one escape option from Puff of being able to just float over your head, right?
Giving yourself air support, so to speak.
Yeah, it's limiting pathways.
No fly zone.
Yeah, exactly.
Both of these characters really do fly, though.
And this will be another timeout. And at this point, it is doable for Puff, is the thing. If Toussaint can get a kill and then a rest, or just a lot of damage. But that necessitates the getting the kill part, which has looked pretty difficult. There's the up throw, the down throw. Toussaint has been so good at getting underneath, like you said.
Yeah.
Oh,
wow.
That should probably do it for this game. Well, okay. Catches Laud sleeping. I mean, still a full stock. Laud will wait on the Angel platform. Has had enough experience in this matchup to know how much those, what is it? Is it 3 seconds on Angel? Four?
I should know this. Like, yeah, I think like 3. Wow.
Man.
Laud creating that platform in the air, just sitting on a platform, even on FD, right above 2. Puff, interestingly enough, can fly, but when Puff's in the air, like, Puff players have to stay mobile. Puff can't really just sit there in the same way Peach can.
Yeah, and you can see Laud getting a lot more hits. That's because Toussaint now has to force the issue. There's just no alternative, right? Toussaint has to force a rest is literally their only way back into this game. Interesting one there. Laud waits out the rest as much as possible. Roll out, sure, wouldn't even kill Peach at this percent, but
I didn't even realize at first that's what Laud was doing. Oh my god.
Yeah, I was waiting out the rest to the maximum.
Yeah.
Toussaint, just taunt, man. Just taunt. You did it when you won. What, you're not going to do it when you lose? This game's over. Taunt. 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 You're...
All right.
Okay. And Laud, unfortunately, not succeeding in padding the stock count stats there. Won't get the kill because of the star KO. Really, really a misplay not to Nair there, I have to say. Nair would kill off the side unless Toussaint DI's up. I don't know if Toussaint's holding down at that point, so you just don't get that stock there. You hate to see it from Laud. But out to a 2-1 lead, and we'll go to Fountain. Interesting. I don't know why. I'm sure there's a good reason. I'm sure this is the accepted way that this goes. But I have to admit, I don't know.
Yeah, I definitely just think that, like, after the last 2 games, 2 is probably a little sick of the long game.
Yeah. I guess Stadium is like FD. Dreamland. Yeah, okay, sure. I guess you die off the top later here, and Laud does go for a lot of up air. Is that it? Sure, maybe. Who knows?
Yeah, maybe it really is.
Death.
Oh my god.
Sorry, I keep cutting you off. Maybe it is what?
Maybe it really is just that, like, Toussaint wants their back air to take up a higher percentage of the stage.
Yeah.
Oh!
Puff's item throw is notoriously terrible.
Oh, really? Okay.
We'll see what Tuzank can do here. Just gonna float around with it for a bit.
Yeah, I know Fox and Sheik have really good item throws, and Marth's is really bad.
Wow, manages to get it, actually. Okay.
When Puff is holding a turn up, oh, another one!
What?
Another one? Another one.
We're at 8 stitches, I think, in this set. Death. Oh no! Not quite. But still so much percentage on Tuesday.
Yeah. When Puff is holding a turn up, doesn't it look like she's like eating it because it's so close to her mouth? I always imagine her like munching down on it.
Kirby mode.
Kirby mode. Wow. Yeah, I don't know. That dash attack felt desperate.
A really different dynamic than we've seen in every other game. Because that Stitch Face gets Lod out to such an early lead, Tuesday is forced to come in so much already.
Yeah, and I feel like, you know, Lod is staying on the side of the stage that doesn't have the platform right now.
Yeah.
And I feel like without the platform, it's very hard for Toussaint to, like, weave around Lod in such a way to get a hit. I feel like every time Toussaint gets a hit that they think will kill, they lean even closer into the screen.
Yep. Back airs should do it soon. A strong back air from the side of the stage. Oh, that was really scary for Tuesday. I cannot believe Puff Shield managed to hold out there.
I know, fantastic shield DI away.
Okay, Tuesday getting that stock without losing their own is really, really, really big. The only way they have a chance in this game. Can they manage to nickel and dime Lod back up to equal percent?
Yeah, it's gonna be a little bit of a grind this stock, but...
And that is rough.
You can see Tuesday shake their head.
Oh! Okay, okay, okay. Lod air dodges to safety, but Arrest was potentially on the cards there with the wrong escape option.
Yeah, I definitely think Lod's first thought there was like, I am not teching on a platform.
No.
Never, 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 never.
Yeah, the air dodge, really good because it denies the rest. Yeah, you might get forward aired afterwards, but that's all good.
You'll be okay. Wow. And dot eyes, too. And I do think we see Lod, like, I love the way that even though they're playing, like, mostly a turnip game,
yeah.
As soon as they can be close, mm-hmm. they transition to, like, a read the roll, chase you around game.
Oh, yeah. Lod has been so good at tracking down Tuesaint's escape option. Excuse me.
Yeah.
Tuesaint, like, this is it. Can see everything in the way that they lean back. I mean, they got Lod to pretty high percent here without taking a Lod in return. If they can close this out soon.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, that was an interesting interaction. The platform raising there, really big, means that Tuesday does not eat a meaty down smash.
Yeah, I mean, these platforms can really kill you with down smash if they do the wrong thing at the wrong time. Okay.
Oh, that's a big hit.
Yeah, I mean, the percent gap was closing, but
That's another one. That's another one also. That's another stitch face.
Another one. Another one? I can't
and
believe
I
it.
I think if Tuesday gets hit by this, it's curtains. Down throw. Doesn't get it. Tuesday gets it with the up smash. The stitch face actually goes Tuesday's way, and now they have another chance. Now they have another chance. Even stocks get to work really hard to get back to this point.
Yeah. I mean, have we seen a single rest this set, though?
No.
And now not being at even stocks can make rest that much harder.
I respect going for it. Tuesday just takes an up air. It's not that big a deal.
Yeah, I mean, at this point, it's really worth it.
Wanted the up tilt rest. Yeah, yep. It has to be rest at this point, right?
I think
we
so.
Know it. Tuesday knows it. Lod knows it. It's the only thing that can really bring us back here. So what's in their bag of tricks? Can they force a roll and read a roll rest? Not really. It doesn't look like they're even getting Lod into situations like that. Oh! Lod just aerials out of shield.
Yeah, I think Lod is not feeling uncomfortable enough to roll, feeling more comfortable to just fight out of shield, throw out aerials. Lod is so happy to go for trades right now.
Mm-hmm.
the turnups. I mean, every turnup does 8%.
And I think actually we're at a percent where rest might be off the table on this stock.
I think
now we definitely are.
Yeah, I think up smash by Peach will kill here. Kuzin's gonna need the kill first and then a rest.
Is this how it's gonna end? I throw it away, Lod. Wait, this is only bad, right?
Oh! And the roll!
That was
wow!
Nice. That was nice. That was good.
I also was thinking, don't risk it. Just throw it away.
Right? But Lod makes it work. Lod makes it work. Mm-hmm. All right. Mm-mm-mm. Another grinder of a set. We were wrong. The average game time was longer than Aklo versus HBox by a significant margin with two timeouts there. Let's see what we have for the replays. Yeah, I mean, this has got to be it, right? In a set full of minute moments, this was the most explosive. Yeah, there we go.
Yeah, Mr. Saturn is a friend to all, but I think Bob-omb's really only a friend to Lod.
What's this? This is the up air kill, right? Mm-hmm. This was cool. This was a cute way to get this stock that really was the reason Toussaint won this game. The stock lead's so huge.
Classic Meta Knight option.
Yeah, yeah. Toussaint played really fearlessly around the stitch faces, which came out so many times. I really think it was maybe 8 or 9 stitch faces in that set.
Oh, yeah.
Like 2 per game.
For sure. I mean, it was an unusual number, even with the number of turnups being pulled.
And yeah, this one was very crucial for Toussaint's chances. Obviously wasn't enough. Look back at us. Look back at the crowd. So have you see that, how I outplayed there? Only got hit by stitch face twice the entire time, right? But I think it made a pretty big difference in that last game.
Yeah, it really did. I mean, normally you see Puff has the sort of X factor, low kill percent option with rest.
Sure.
Normally you don't see a matchup where someone has that on Puff, but Toussaint did not land a single rest.
Yeah, I'm trying to think how HBox usually gets rest on Lod. They're still rare, because Lod plays around it so much and doesn't get into that space. I feel like a lot of the time it's off up air at low percents when they're forcing Lod to be above them and then an up air comes out. I feel like that's how he usually does it.
That's what I was thinking too. I was thinking shark up air or falling up air,
yeah.
Like down on a roll read.
Yeah.